In June 2011, aliens landed Taylor on the Earth. He pulled out his magical framework and put it on the GitHub, and yeah, it grew in popularity and made the elephants happy again. Companies started using Laravel in their own projects, and thousands of packages, tools, and services were built around that. Among the current ecosystem of Laravel, 19 of them have the honor to be on its website, and in this video, we are going to have a fast introduction for each one of them. To make things easier to remember, I have categorized them into their related groups. Let's start with the Socialite package. We all love single sign-ins. I often run away from the websites that require me to fill up a form for registration. Socialite library provides this feature for Laravel with a very easy setup. Install the library, configure the providers that you want, let's say in this case GitHub. You can generate credentials with creating new GitHub OAuth application. Create two routes, one for redirecting user to grant us permission via GitHub, and another one for redirecting user back to our own project. Once user grants us permission, we can access the user information with this sample code and create the user in our own database.
I did it! It was so easy!
Laravel Sanctum. Many API-based applications use barrier tokens to authenticate users' requests. Sanctum makes it very easy to create and manage tokens and also control abilities of each token. After installing the package, add has API token trait to user model, then you can create tokens for users and send them back to them. And for protecting routes, put auth sanctum middleware on them. You can also add abilities to tokens and authorize users for individual actions. And of course, you can check those abilities both in the routes and your codes.
Great!
Sanctum has also support for single page application authentication, which uses Laravel's default sessions and cookies instead of tokens and works on web routes. To learn more about this, please check Laravel's documentation page. Laravel Scout. Most database full text indexes are not good enough in practice. If you want fuzzy search capability and prevent mean users from rumbling, services like Algolia, MeleeSearch, or Elasticsearch can help here. When you create, save, or delete the models, Scout keeps your searchable data in sync with the search engine. When you search on your model, Scout queries search engine for results and fetches matching rows from database. To use Scout, set up the requirements. In this example, we are using MeleeSearch. Add searchable trait to your model and optionally customize the searchable fields. Create new rows with your model, then test your search to see how it works. Laravel Echo. Modern web applications utilize WebSockets for live updating user interfaces and push real-time messages to front-end. Since PHP instances respond per each request and die afterwards, we need some help to provide this feature. In Laravel, it's easy to broadcast events over a broadcasting service like Pusher Channels or Ably. Then, in the front-end, receive the messages in real-time with the help of Laravel Echo, which is a JavaScript library and is connected to broadcasting channel via WebSocket. With the help of this setup, you can inform users of delayed tasks, notify them of important events, and even create a real-time chat application. Since the setup is a little tricky for Laravel Echo, please check out the video in description for more details. Laravel Nova. Developers love creativity, but creating admin panel is a painful process, mostly because of coding repetitive breaths. Taylor have built a beautiful and customizable admin panel with Vue.js to rapidly get over this headache. It has the most common functionalities with a clean documentation like Laravel, which can give Uncle Bob the idea for his next book.
What a great name!
To name few features of Nova, it's easy to create breads with support for eloquent relations and data validation. Put custom filters on data and even change underline eloquent query with lenses. Create custom actions with queuing capability. Do global search with the help of Scout package. Control authorizations with Laravel policies. Create custom theme and many other features. Laravel Horizon. One of the Laravel's great features is the easy to set up queues for processing time consuming jobs in background. Horizon provides a beautiful dashboard to monitor and manage your queues in Redis. It gives you metrics to see your workloads during time for each one of your jobs and queues. You can see your pending jobs list and click on any of them to see them in details. You can check your completed or failed jobs, and also Horizon gives you the convenience to retry the failed jobs in the UI. To name some of the options in its configuration, you can write your queue workers configurations in a single file and leave it to Horizon to manage them for you. You can also ask him to send notifications when queues have long wait time. To use Horizon, install the package, configure the environments, then run Horizon and push some jobs to see how it works. If you want to run it in the system startup, you can create a supervisor configuration on Linux.
What about Windows containers? Because I've read somewhere that they exist.
Definitely.
Sail. It helps you to build a development environment for Laravel inside Docker blazingly fast. Sail contains default Docker files for PHP and Node versions and Docker Compose file, including different options for database, cache, search engine, mail service, file storage, and many more. You can also share your local sites over the internet to test and get feedbacks. To start using Sail in new project, run this command to install it, create an alias for Sail command, then you can start and stop your app with Sail up and Sail stop. To run your Artisan, Composer, or other commands that needs to be run in your Docker instances, you should use Sail command to execute them inside your containers. Since Docker installation varies for each operating system, check out the video description for the links to tutorials based on your OS. Valet. If you are an Apple fan and buy a monitor stand for $1,000 to impress the people and lose your money, the macOS Minimalistic Green Development Environment Valet is for you. Basically, Valet configures macOS to always run Nginx in the background, then using DNS mask redirect .test URLs to your local sites. So unlike Sail, it does not provision database or other services and is not a complete replacement for it. But it's so simple and very lightweight with 7 megabytes of RAM usage and has some great features. Sharing local sites via ngrok or expose, sharing them on your local network, and TLS setup with a single command. Laravel Telescope. Debugging code takes a lot of time and is better than reading 5 minutes documentation. Telescope does a wonderful job here. Within Telescope panel, you can see the requests coming into your application with so much details. Inside each request, you can see its payload, headers, session values, and the response that was given back to the user. And this is not all of them. It gives you a report on anything that was involved to process the request, like models, database queries, cache misses or hits, blade views, and much more. In other tabs, you can see the commands that you have run so far. Telescope also keeps records of Laravel scheduler execution times. In the next tab, it shows you all the jobs which are created with their status and details. The panel has so many options to cover here, so I can only name few of the remained ones. It has a separate section for batches, cache, debugging dumps, events, exceptions, gates, logs, mail. To use Telescope, install it via Composer with dev option. Run its migrations. Since we have installed it with dev option, you should make sure that it only loads in local environment. Open its default panel URL in browser and enjoy using it. Laravel Dask. Laravel ships with PHP unit, which makes it possible to do unit tests and feature tests. But sometimes we need to run tests on an actual browser, like opening a page, filling up a form and submitting it, and see if it works correctly from the user's perspective. Of course, it's all going to be done by code. For example, take a look at this test. And here, we are trying to test our login functionality. Our example test class is extended from Dask test case, and we have used database migrations trait to remigrate database before each test. Now, we start testing by adding a user to our database to try the login process for him. By using browse method, we actually ask Dask to run a headless browser in background and go to the login page. Then it should type in the email and password and press login button in our behalf. Now, we assert that browser redirects to homepage, which means that login process was successful. Dask actually uses the Chrome driver to run tests behind the scene, but you can change it to use Selenium or other options. To set it up, install Google Chrome and Dask's Composer package with dev option. Make sure that app URL environment value is correct. Generate a new test file and start writing some tests with the help of its documentation. And run your test with Artisan Dask command. So far, we could cover 10 out of 19 items in our list. This was my first video and it definitely has so many problems. So please write your thoughts and critics about the video, and if you liked it, please subscribe to the channel for energizing me to create the second part with better quality to make it finally worth your time. Hope to see you soon.
Check, no restraints, I'm obsessed with the pain. I ingest, I retain, assess and I change. Possessed by the thought I'll be free one day from society's restraints. Money, clout and fame, mud, disease, a plague. We all love to hate, have to play the game, have to make a name. All our insecurities are on display.
This is war with the enemy.